Rapper Half Ounce, the latest rapper to get bodied in LA. Now, the topic of today is LA a graveyard for rappers? Now, I know nothing about this rapper named Half Ounce. In fact, like most new rappers of today, I'm just learning about him after somebody snuffed him. So, the report that I did read about Half Ounce is he was in Koreatown. He was talking to his girl on the phone where some guys in an SUV lit him up like a Christmas tree. As of this commentary, the police are still investigating as to who was behind it. So they are looking for suspects. But it brings a question. Well, before I bring the question up, let's take a quick look at Half Ounce's music video. Gangbanger, where you from, nigga? Throw it up. Put the chronic in the blunt, nigga. Roll it up. They hit the switches on the bitches that was acting funny. Chunk the B up on they niggas like it's crack, dummy. Gangbanger, where you from, nigga? Throw it up. Put the chronic in the blunt, nigga. Roll it up. They hit the switches on the bitches that was acting funny. Chunk the B up on they niggas like it's crack, dummy. Yeah, my niggas down with the limes. Avenue 40 rules, food towns to the skyline. Elm Street, Lucas Park, Village Town, way to the V. 151, 135, west side to the 2P. Can't forget about the mob, Cabanellas and 30 rules, Hollywood, across Atlantic, ghost town, the center view, Cabbage Pack, Sky Park, Warlords to the Scottsdales, Waterfront, Circuit City, different lanes in the PDL. Alright, what you just watched was a snippet of Half Ounce's music video. If you're interested in seeing it, it's in entirety. The link is in the description box. Now let's get right back to the question. Is LA a graveyard for rappers? The answer is yes, because the events thus far would come to the conclusion that L.A. has become a mortuary or a mausoleum for rap artists. We had Biggie Smalls, obviously. We had Nipsey Hussle. We have Jayco the Ruler. We had Pop Smoke, we had PNB Rock, Key Rich, and now Half Ounce. Half Ounce, you know, as I reflect on the tragedy that befallen Half Ounce, it is very sad. He leaves behind a wife, three kids, and one kid on the way. And as I was doing research for this commentary, I discovered that there's a GoFundMe for Half Ounce. There apparently, I think either his mother or his wife is raising funds for his funeral or burial expenses, which begs the question, why don't these rappers have life insurance? You would think with all that's going on and everything and the fact that none of us are promised to live or see another day, that you would have some life insurance in events like this instead of just leaving it up to your loved ones to fit the bill. For all you rappers that are still here and that are above ground, seriously consider investing in some life insurance. Don't leave it up to your mama, your pops, your siblings, or even your girl to fit the bill for you. Make things easier for them and get some life insurance. It's not even that expensive either. If you could afford the latest gear, the latest footwear, and a nice whip, and all that other stuff, and some chains, I'm sure you can rock some life insurance too. So get some life insurance. That's all I gotta say about that. Yeah, so as I think about all the tragedy that befallen some of these rappers in the City of Angels, one would conclude that it's really not safe for rappers, regardless of whether you're from elsewhere or whether you're a native of LA as a rapper, because there's a lot of dangers. A lot of dangers that you know about or don't know about. And the thing that some of y'all really need to consider is taking proper precautions. Especially if you're going to be in street situations here. It doesn't really make any sense to be in a low-income area wearing expensive chains and rolling up in a Maybach. Not saying that you shouldn't have nice things or you can't have nice things, but you have to carefully consider where you're going and where you're wearing those nice things at and who you wearing those nice things around. And two, if you could afford nice things, then I'm sure you could afford security. The same thing if you could afford nice things, I'm sure you could afford to get some life insurance. And the last part is some of y'all are gonna need to really be mindful of how you move and navigate on social media as well as in real life. Because you're making it way too easy for your ops to have access to you. So I would suggest getting some security, getting some thorough security. I think some of y'all need a convoy as far when you're going into certain places and situations and everything so you can be safe. Because if you could afford some chains, some nice threads, some nice footwear, and a nice whip, you definitely could afford security. If you can't afford to wear it, you can't afford to protect it. To quote Charlemagne the God. And this isn't going to be my only commentary on this. I intend to do follow-ups on this particular issue because I feel that there's a lot more to say on this situation. I feel that we're in rappers, the young rappers are in danger now. So there really needs to be a call to arms here. So I'm going to end this right here. So tell me, audience, what do you think? Please like, comment, and subscribe. And share this mother effing video like my man Nuno Brown would say. This is Iron Will Media.